Psalm 1. Let's speak it together, please. Blessed. Everyone say blessed.
Blessed.
What's the opposite of blessed?
Cursed.
Blessed is the man who what? Does not walk, who walks not in the what? Counsel of the ungodly. That's rebellious. Amen. Blessed is that person who rejects ungodly counsel, nor stands in the path of sinners and liars and so forth, immorals, nor sits with the seat of the scornful, perverse tongues. But his delight is in the law or the truth of the Lord. And in his law or truth, he does what? He meditates day and night. In other words, it's always before him. And in his law, he meditates day and night. He shall be like a what? A tree. A what?
Tree.
A tree planted by the what? Rivers of water that brings forth its fruit in its seasons, whose leaf shall not wither. And whatever he does shall what? Prosper. Prosper according to the will of the Lord, not according to the will of man. See, he can prosper according to the will of man. But it's a terrible thing to be successful in the wrong assignment. Amen. The ungodly, the rebellious ones, are not so, but are like the chaff which the wind drives away. Therefore, the ungodly shall not stand in the reward or judgment, nor sinners in the congregation of the righteous. For the Lord knows the way of the righteous, but the way of the ungodly shall what? Perish. You know, as we are praising and worshiping, you know, in the arena that we are not only children of God, but we are offsprings of God's grace. Amen. We are more than who we think we are. Do not let the mirror dictate who you are. Do not let the world dictate who you are. Do not let your past dictate who you are. Do not let your failures dictate who you are. Do not let your successes dictate who you are. You are dictated in who you are, what God says who you are, and that's that. Does everybody get it? And in this, he's saying, look it. Because one of the things is people are getting so much ungodly counsel. In fact, the word says that in the latter days, many will take heed to deceiving spirits and doctrines of demons. Their ears will become itchy because they want to do what they want to do, so they'll look for places that say what they want to do in an ungodly fashion. They'll approve of it. But I'm telling you right now that those who reject these things and want to do the right thing before God because of the righteousness that's in them, because they have a thirst and hunger to please God, because they know who they are and their identity is being restored to them. See, the enemy always wants to steal your identity and who you are. You will drink. You will be filled. You will carry God's love and truth. And as we are praising and worshiping, I saw a beach. A beautiful beach. And behind the beach was all like foliage and all kinds of trees and green. On the beach, like almost like an island. And I saw many people coming out of these bushes and all kinds of. And as they began to walk towards the ocean, many stood there. And there were those who were running out and diving in the water. See, we are river children. We love the river of life. We love to drink from the fountain of life. But there were many who still stood on the beach. And they watched. Because of influence. See, they were looking at all those that were diving in the water and just going deep, man, just going for it. And the other ones were going, how can you just dive in that water and not understand where you're going? See, because fear was holding them back. I want you to know that ungodly counsel will always promote fear. Always. And these individuals, Now, I want you to understand that God was calling them all. But many were standing on a beach, and on a beach, it's dry. It's dry. But many were diving in the water and just going. And they weren't coming back to the beach. They just kept going. And this is where we are right now. This is what's happening. This is what God is doing right now in this season. See, the will of God has entered the White House, not the will of man. And there's a change and shift, but there is rebellion. You know, I was praying this morning, and I saw all of these protesters, and the Lord said, the only thing they're protesting is my will. And you can't protest my will. Most of them don't even know what the heck they're protesting. They're just out there because everybody else is out there. I saw them interview some people and thought, some of the answers are the most ridiculous thing. Well, we want our rights back. Well, no one's taking your right, idiot. I mean, there was so much dumb stuff why people were gathering. But again, because of ungodly influence. And they're not resisting the individual put in office. They're resisting the will of God that's been put in office. Does everybody understand that? And there is a lot of things that are going to happen. We are entering a whole nother realm. You haven't seen the resistance yet. There'll be much. Much. Why? Because the enemy hates God's will. And he's out to steal, kill, and destroy. But as long as you keep swimming, you got no problem. Philippians chapter 2. And Matthew 25, in which we don't have to go there, that there was wise virgins and foolish virgins. There were those who were staying filled with God's presence in the oil and keeping their lamps lit. And then there are those who did not. In other words, they drifted. They fell. They took ungodly counsel. And that influence began to prevent them from drinking and from eating from the will of God. In Philippians chapter 2, is everybody there? And we'll start at verse 1. Would you read it with me, please? Therefore, if there's any consolation in Christ, if any comfort of love, if any fellowship of the Spirit, if any affection and mercy, fulfill my joy by being what? Like-minded. Having the same love, being of one accord and of one mind. See, this is what you're seeing. You're seeing the separation of the mind of Christ and the mind of the Antichrist. The Antichrist is a spirit. There will be an Antichrist that will come, but there's a spirit of Antichrist that influences individuals. It's associated with the prince of power of error. And there is a separation and there's a battle, but people aren't willing to search or expose what's influencing them. He said, verse 3, let nothing be done through selfish ambition or conceit, but in lowliness of mind, let each esteem others better than himself. Let each of you look out not only for his own interests, but also for the interests of others. Let this mind be in you, which was what? Also in Christ Jesus, who being in a form of God did not consider robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation, taking a form of a bondservant and coming in the likeness of men. And being found in appearance as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even the death of the cross. How many of you know God wants you to become obedient to the point of death? Therefore, what? God has highly exalted him and given him the name which is above every name, that the name of Jesus every knee should bow, of those in heaven and those on earth and those under earth, and that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Therefore, my beloved, as you have always obeyed, not as in my presence only, but now much more in my absence, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. That's a phenomenal statement. Work out your salvation. Work out with what? Fear and trembling. Why? Because you can turn it over. Just like Esau, who sold his birthright, that's one of the things the enemy wants you to do. And it all starts first with losing your identity. For it is God who works in you both to will and to what? Do for his good pleasure. Do all things without what? Complaining and disputing, that you may become blameless and harmless, children of God without fault in the midst of a what? Well, in the midst of a what? A crooked and perverse generation, among whom you shine as lights in the world. We are in the generation that is becoming the most perverse and crooked. Look at what just left the White House. That was the most crooked and perverse president we've ever had. Hallelujah. Some people won't like that, but that's just the way it is. Hallelujah. So, we are in a crooked and perverse generation. We are in the midst at home in whom our lights should shine. Amen? Holding fast the what? Word of what? Verse 16. Holding fast the word of life, so that I may rejoice in the day of Christ, that I have not run in vain or labored in vain. Very powerful. First of all, he says, look, he wants us to be like-minded with the mind of Christ. He said, you are among a generation that is the most perverse. It's gaining worse and worse. It's crooked. He said, the only way that you're going to shine your light is, he said here, is holding fast to the word of life. The word of what? Life, which is the word of what? God. That's the only way. He tells us something very powerful here then. He said that your light should be shining amongst men. And the only way that it can shine is by being connected. Maintaining your connection. And get disconnected from the world and stay connected to him in every area of your life. Why? If Jesus was to show up right now, anyone who's disconnected would not be taken home. In Luke 17, everyone say, I'm a light bearer. So since we are the light bearers who love to stay saturated with the presence of God, we must continue to stay filled with the oil so that our light can continue to stay bright. In Luke 17 and verse 22, and let's speak it together. Then Jesus said to the disciples, the days will come when you will desire to see one of the days of the Son of Man, and you will not see it. In other words, you will have a desire for his return. Amen. And they will say to you, look here and look there. Do not go after them or follow them. Why would you have a desire for the return of the Lord? Because things are getting perverse and crooked. In other words, there is a generation that God has said that it will be perverse and crooked. And in that generation, I'm coming. In verse 24, let's read it. For as the lightning that flashes out of one part under heaven shines to the other part under heaven, so also the Son of Man will be in his day. But first he must suffer many things and be rejected by the generation. Listen, if Jesus is going to suffer many things and be rejected, will you and I? Yes. Because this is the generation. And as it was in the what? Days of Noah. So it will be also in the days of the Son of Man. They ate, they drank, they married wives, they were given in marriage. They married wives and they were given in marriage. Hello. How can you marry? Okay, if you marry a wife and then you were given in marriage, means that's the wrong kind of marriage. Amen. As it was in the days of Noah, so also be in the sons that they ate, they drank, they married wives, they were given in marriage until the day that Noah entered the ark and the flood came and destroyed them all. Likewise, it was also with the days of Lot. So he says it's going to be the day, it will be a generation, it will be like the days of Noah and the days of Lot, which we have entered. This is it. They ate, they drank, they bought, they sold, they planted, they built. But on the day that Lot went out of Sodom, it rained fire and brimstone from heaven and destroyed them all. Wow. This is the generation. We are the days of Noah. We are the days of Lot, or Sodom and Gomorrah. Both were destroyed by a flood and fire because both generations were rebellious and perverse. Liars, sexual conduct, stealing, killing, with open influence from demonic realm because of the unwillingness to seek truth. Unwillingness to seek truth. Even so, so-called believers are not willing to seek truth. We live in this generation. There are so-called believers not willing to seek truth. Ephesians chapter 2. Light bearers. Can't be a light bearer unless you get filled. And the word warns us, don't let your light become what? Darkness. Ephesians chapter 2, verse 1. Is everybody there? Let's speak it together. It says, in you he made alive who were dead in trespasses and sins, in which you once walked according to what? The course of this world. The curse of this world. The course of this world. According to the what? The prince of the power of air, who is an antichrist spirit. It is rebellious to the will of God. The spirit who now works in the sons of what? Disobedience. That all these people that are rebellion, all these people that are protesting, they don't even know what they're doing. They do not know that they're influenced. They think they're fighting for a cause. They're looking for entitlement. They think their rights are being removed. Well, actually, righteousness is being restored. Amen. The spirit who now works in the sons of disobedience, among whom also we all once conducted ourselves in the what? Lust of our flesh, fulfilling the desires of the flesh and of the mind, and were by nature children of what? Wrath, just as the others. So you're, look at, if you're under ungodly counsel or influence, then you're not producing righteousness, nor do you have a desire to do the will of God. That makes you a child of wrath, God's wrath. And nobody escapes it. Nobody. Everybody will stand before God Almighty. But see, people do not see that far. They don't realize that every decision you make is either on a pathway of eternity or a pathway of hell. Verse 4. But God, who is rich in mercy because of his great love with which he loved us, even when we were dead in trespasses, he made us alive together with Christ. For by grace you've been saved, and raised us up together, and made us sit together in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. that in the ages to come he might show the exceeding riches of his grace and his kindness towards us in Christ Jesus. For by grace you have been saved through faith, and that not of yourselves. It is a what? It's a gift, not of works, lest anyone should boast. Can you give a gift away? Amen. For we are as what? Workmanship, created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared beforehand, that we should what? That we should walk in them. In other words, the prince of power air. Those who are under the prince of power air are children of wrath. That is this generation. Unless they practice righteousness in turn, they are considered children of wrath. He said, walk in what? Walk in his character. Walk in his integrity. Walk. In 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 10. Let's speak it, please. But you have what? Carefully followed my doctrine. What's the doctrine? Word. It's called the gospel. It's a message of truth. Manner of life, purpose, faith, long-suffering, love, and perseverance. Persecutions, afflictions, which happened to me at Antioch, at Iconium, and Lystra. Which persecutions I endured, and out of them all the Lord delivered me. How many of y'all know that God can deliver you out of everything? Amen. Everything. If you let them. It's when we try to do it, we sink. Yes, and all who desire to live godly in Christ Jesus will what? Suffer persecution. You will be persecuted. People will not agree with what you believe. And that's okay. Because if you believe the word, that's all that matters. But evil men and imposters will grow worse and worse, deceiving and being deceived. But you must continue in the things which you have learned and been assured of, knowing from whom you have learned them, and that from childhood you have known the Holy Scriptures, which is what? Able to make you wise for salvation through faith, which is in Christ Jesus. All Scripture is given by inspiration of God. And it is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in what? Righteousness. That the man or woman of God may be complete, thoroughly equipped for every good work. We will be persecuted. There will be persecution because of those unwilling to read the Word of God with the interpretation of the Holy Spirit. There's many people who read the Word of God and they still don't get it. I've heard people say, yeah, I read the Word of that Bible 3 times. And he's still an idiot. Because there's no interpretation. I read it 3 times. Like, it was a book. It's a manual, training manual. So there will be persecution because of the unwillingness of individuals to read the Word of God with interpretation by the Holy Spirit. They cannot practice righteousness or discern evil influence. They cannot. Because it only can be interpreted by the Holy Spirit. It comes by eating. Jesus said, here it is. You want to be like me? You must eat me. Eat my flesh and drink my blood. That's called partaking. Did you ever see somebody come out with a pie or a cake? And they cut a piece of it. See, when they give you the piece of it, you partake of that. That's what Jesus did. He gave us himself so that you and I can partake of him. His word that we eat, and his spirit, his blood that we drink, so we can become more like him. In Mark 13, We are the generation of perverse and crooked. Mark 13. There are more murders and executions than there has ever been. People do not realize the persecution of Christians through the rest of the world that are being hung, burned alive, crucified, beheaded, and it's going to continue to get worse. But we must let our light shine, no matter what. We stand firm. We must have boldness to stay what, to decree what the truth is. And who cares? We must get to a place where I don't care. Why? Because God is my provider. God is my source. Not man, not my boss, no one. God is my boss. Amen? Mark 13, in verse 9. He says what? But watch out for yourselves, for they will deliver you up to the councils, and you will be beaten in the synagogues. You will be brought before rulers and kings for my sake, for a testimony to them. And the gospel, which is the message of truth, must first be preached to all nations. But when they arrest you and deliver you up, do not worry beforehand or premeditate what you will speak. But whatever is given you in that hour, speak that. For it is not you who speak, but the Holy Spirit. Now, brother will betray brother to death. This is true believers will be betrayed by fake believers. And father his children, and children will rise up against parents and cause them to be put to death. And you will be hated by all for my name's sake, but he who endures to the end shall be saved. He who endures to the end shall be saved. In Matthew 24. Light bearers. We are in need of endurance, not wimpiness. There's a time to be quiet. There's a time to speak. There's a time to sow, there's a time to reap, there's a time to pray, there's a time to attack. Amen? Amen. But don't compromise what God's word says when it's time. Amen. There's a time to tell the truth. How many of y'all know truth hurts sometimes? Hallelujah. Matthew 24, 29. Would you read it with me? Immediately after tribulation of those days, the sun will be darkened, and the moon will not give its light, and the stars will fall from heaven, and the powers of heaven will be shaken. Then the sign of the Son of Man will appear in heaven, and then all the tribes of the earth will mourn, and they will see the Son of Man coming on the clouds of heaven with power and great glory. And he will send out his angels with a great sound of the of a trumpet. Hello. It's no coincidence God placed a trump in the office. And they will gather together his elect from the four winds, from one end of heaven to the other. Now learn the parable from the fig tree. When its branches have already become tender and puts forth leaves, you know that summer is near. So you also, when you see all these things, know that it is near at the door. Assuredly, I say to you, this generation, what generation? The crooked and perverse generation that is going to be associated with the combination of Sodom and Gomorrah and Noah, which is this generation, will by no means pass away till all these things take place. Now, heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will by no means pass away. But of the day and hour, no one knows, not even the angels of heaven, but my Father only. But as the days of Noah we're all also so becoming of the Son of Man. Now listen, this is so powerful because in this generation, it talks about the, learn the parable of the fig tree. The fig tree is Israel. Israel became a nation in 1948. Again, a generation is 70 years. 1948 plus 70 equals 2018. So we know something very prophetically and specifically. We don't know the exact day and time, and we could even be off by a few years or whatever. But he said that he would return in this generation. Now, I want you to understand something. His return in this generation, he is coming through me and you first. He will not come unless he comes through the body. So when we see all kinds of things breaking out and the power of God hitting every area, we know that he is coming. Why? Because they're going to come against you more and more and more. They will persecute us. They will hate us because we stand for the boldness of what the truth is because of what he says, not what man says. And we will see more and more of boldness, more and more people come to Christ as the harvest continues to get larger and larger. But then it says that people will become more perverse, more wicked, more evil. But I'm telling you, he's coming through us first. And that may, so if we're looking at 2018, that means he's coming through us first. And he may come through us for 5-6 years. Who knows? Until he chooses to come himself. Does everybody understand that? But we are that generation where he will come in a powerful, powerful way. We're the ones. Because we love the river. Yeah. We are light bearers. He will come through the light bearers. He will not come through ones that are fake. You know, they're talking about fake news. With this fake Christians, fake news, all the same thing. Having a form of godliness but denying the power. Amen. In Matthew 12. What's it say? When an unclean spirit goes out of a man, that's called a demon. Let's not, you know, water this down at all. It's a demon. When an unclean spirit comes out of a man, he goes through dry places seeking rest and finds none. Then he says, I will return to my house or to the body I came out of, from whom which I came. And when he comes, he finds it empty and swept and put in order. Then he goes and takes with him seven other demons or spirits more wicked than himself. And they enter and dwell there. And the last state of that man is worse than the first. What does he say next? So shall it also be with this wicked generation. In other words, he's saying that there'll be more demonic possession of individuals. There'll be more drug abuse. There'll be more addictions. There'll be more sexual perversions. There'll be more and more of demonic possessions of individuals. Why? Because there's more technology for access to possess individuals than there's ever been. Is everybody okay? Because the will of God has entered the White House and will begin to spread, but many will protest the will of God with no effect. Many will turn to God during this period of time. But many will run from God, not willing to seek the truth. So we are the light bearers. We are the extension of the will of God. And this, no matter where you are. Listen, your ministry is right where you are. 24/7. You don't need a pulpit. You are the temple of God Almighty. Your ministry is wherever you are. Does everybody got that? 2 Peter chapter 1. Whether you're in school, there's your ministry. Whether you're on a tennis court or playing basketball, there's your ministry. Whether you're bowling, there's your ministry. Whether you're swimming, Just minister to the fish. Jesus catches the fish before he cleans them, right? Praise God. Woohoo! 2 Peter chapter 1. Is everybody there? Light bearers. Everyone say, I'm a light bearer.
I'm a light bearer.
To those who have obtained like precious what? Faith. With us by the righteousness of our God and Savior Jesus Christ. Verse 2. Grace and peace be multiplied to you in the knowledge of God. In the what? Knowledge of God and of Jesus our Lord. And his divine power has given us all things that pertain to life and godliness through the knowledge of him who called us by glory and virtue, by which have been given to us exceedingly great, precious, and what? Promises. What are those promises? Where are they? They're in God's word. These are God. See, God's word is called knowledge. Faith is based on knowledge. And faith is also based on your experiences. Amen? Because of the word of God. But he says here, look at. You've been given, that's been given to us exceedingly and great, precious promises, that through these things you may be what? Partakers. Partakers. Partakers of what? The divine nature. Having escaped the corruption that is in the world through what? Lust. Lust is an overwhelming desire, isn't it? Addiction is nothing but lust. There's three categories. Lust of the eye, lust of the flesh, and pride of life. That's it. There's a bunch of stuff underneath it, fruits of those three. But it's still lust. It's an overwhelming desire. So the divine nature, you and I to be partakers. Again, it's like taking a piece of pie. Jesus said, he who eats of my flesh and drinks my blood is a partaker of the divine nature. But there are so many people out there who do not know or believe the word of God. They have no interpretation of the Holy Spirit. So it doesn't become illuminated, nor does it become revelation to them. So where there's no revelation, there's no restraints. Why? Because revelation brings a reverence, honor, and respect called the fear of the Lord to God. When there's no revelation, people lose the fear of God. And it says, work out your salvation with what? Fear and trembling. That's why many people give up their salvation, sell their birthright for the lust of the world, lust of the flesh, and pride of life. There's no such thing as once saved, always saved. Or he wouldn't say, work out your salvation. Hello? And he warns us. He said, many will come to me that day and say, Lord, Lord. And they're going to give excuse of all the works they did for Jesus. But he said, you practice lawlessness. Why? You broke covenant. Anyone who willfully sins is no longer protected. It's all in the word. But people don't read the word with their interpretation by the Spirit. Does everybody understand? Oh, verse 5. But also for this very reason, giving all diligence, add to your faith virtue, to virtue knowledge, to knowledge self-control, to self-control perseverance, to perseverance godliness, to godliness brotherly kindness, and to brotherly kindness love. For these things are yours and abound. If they are yours and abound, you will what? Neither be barren or what? Unfruitful in the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. Verse 9, for he who what? Lacks these things is what? Short-sighted, even to blindness, and has forgotten that he was cleansed from his old sins. Therefore, brethren, be even more diligent to make your call and election sure. For if you do these things, you will never stumble. For so an entrance will be supplied to you abundantly in an everlasting kingdom of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. See, one of the things people don't realize is that associations bring impartations. They think just because that they've gone to church that they can go out and hang around with people that are carrying ungodly counsel. The spirits that they carry will bite you. And next thing you know, you'll be fighting. That's why the word says, do not be unevenly yoked with unbelievers. You got to work with them. You're to be the light to them. Amen? But it doesn't mean that you agree with them. We're to love all mankind, regardless of what. People are not bad. They're just deceived. Whether they're homosexuals, lesbians, addicts, liars, cheaters, whatever, even murderers. They're not bad. They're deceived. And God desires to rescue them all. But you know what? What you listen to will promote a right act, a righteous act, or an unrighteous act. And then people will look at it as a bad decision or a good decision. Amen. Oh, hallelujah. Let's go a little further. Again, faith is based on the knowledge of the word and also based on your experience of his presence. It's the experience of his presence. 1 John chapter 3. There is life and death in the power of the tongue. So what you speak is what you eat. And what you eat is what you become. I encourage everyone at some time today in the prayer booklet. It's called Label Breaking Prayer. Speak it. Vitally important at this time. 1 John chapter 3 and verse 7. Let's speak it together. 1 John chapter 3, verse 7. Little children, let no one do what? Deceive you. He who practices righteousness is righteous, just as he is righteous. So are you going to hang around with people that don't practice righteousness, even though they call themselves Christians? No. They're fakies. He who sins is of the devil. Hello. For the devil sinned from the beginning. For this purpose the Son of God was manifested, that he might destroy the works of the devil. Whoever has been born of God does not sin, for his seed remains in him, and he cannot sin because he has been born of God. In other words, there is no desire to sin. Doesn't mean he won't make a mistake. In this, the children of God and the children of the devil are what? Manifested. Whoever does not practice righteousness is not of God. Hello. Why? You know them by their fruit. So if they approve of abortion, same-sex marriage, and lying and cheating, you know that they're not of God, even though that they carry a Bible with them. Ooh. Whoever does not practice righteousness is not of God, nor is he who does not love his brother. For this is the message that you heard from the beginning, that we should love one another, not as Cain, who was of the wicked one and murdered his brother. And why did he murder his brother? Because his works were evil and his were righteous. Wow. Do not marvel, my brethren, if the world does what? If the world does what? Hates you. We know that we have passed from death to life because we love the brethren. He who does not love his brother abides in death. And whoever hates his brother is a murderer. And you know that no murderer has eternal life abiding in him. Hebrews 6. You know, there's a difference between love and like. Does everybody understand it? I may not. We're to love everyone. It's because we're concerned about everyone. But you don't have to like everyone. Hello. And why? Because of what they practice, you may not like. But you understand that it's not them, it's what's in them. Because of the influence. Hebrews 6. Of course, you got to remember that the enemy is going to twist everything you say and say, you hate? Yes, I hate crime. No, I hate evil. You and I are to hate evil, but not people. Verse 9, Hebrews 6, 9. But beloved, we are confident, amen, of better things concerning you. Yes, things that accompany salvation, though we speak in this manner. For God is not unjust to forget your work and labor of love, which you have shown toward his name, and that you have ministered to the saints and do minister. And we desire that each one of you show the same diligence to the full assurance of hope until the end. That you do not become what? Sluggers, compromisers, complacent, lazy. But imitate those who through faith and patience inherit the what? The promises. Praise God. For when God made a promise to Abraham, because he could swear by no one greater, he swore it by himself, saying, surely, blessing I will bless you, and multiplying I will multiply you. And so after he had patiently endured, he obtained the what? After when he endured, he obtained the promise. Praise God. Hebrews 10. Imitate those through faith who inherit the promise. Hebrews 10, verse 35. Verse 35, let's speak it. Therefore, do not what? Do not what? Do not what?
Cast away.
Cast away. Don't throw it away. Your confidence, which has great reward. In other words, don't cast away your connection. Don't throw it away. It's got great reward. For you have need of what? Endurance. It's called patience also. So that after you have done the will of God, you may receive the promise. What do you have to do first? The will of God. But you must desire to do the will of God. Amen. You must seek the will of God, and you got to know truth, because if you're not willing to do the will of God, then you're lost, living outside of salvation's truth. L-O-S-T. Verse 37, for yet a little while, and he who is coming will come and will not tarry. Now the just shall live by faith, but if anyone draws back, my soul has no pleasure in him. For we are not of those who draw back to perdition, but those who believe to the saving of the soul. 2 Corinthians 4. So you must do the will of God to receive the promise. So that means you must do the will of God to enter eternity. One of the wills of God is repent, turn from your sins. Amen? Sometimes that's all the time you have before you give up your last breath. Hallelujah. Let's speak it. Therefore, since we have this ministry, as we have received mercy, do not lose heart. In other words, don't give up. So you make mistakes. Get up, shake the dust off, and grow for it. Verse 2. Learn from your mistakes. Amen? But we have renounced the hidden things of shame, not walking in craftiness nor handling the word of God deceitfully, but by manifestation of the truth, commending ourselves to every man's conscience in the sight of God. Why? Because we're light bearers. But even if our message of truth, which is called the gospel, is veiled or blinded, it is veiled or blinded to those who are what? They are perishing. They are dying. They are going to hell. Whose minds the God of this age has blinded. The God of this age is Satan. Who do not believe. The word believe here means follow. Because if they truly believe, they would be following. But they don't even know what they're following because they don't read the word of God. Who do not believe, lest the light of the gospel. I said the light of the gospel. Why? Because God's word produces light. The light of the gospel of the glory of Christ, who is the image of God, should shine on them. I'm telling you, I've spoken to many people who claim to be believers, but they don't believe the word of God. Isn't that incredible? Then how can you be a believer? They're not. They're fakies. It's fake news. Everybody got it? For we do not preach ourselves, but Christ Jesus the Lord, and ourselves your bondservants for Jesus' sake. For it is God who commanded light to shine out of darkness, who has shone in our hearts to give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ. But we have this treasure in earthen vessels, that excellence of the power may be of God and not us. That is a light bearer. Does everybody get this? We are light bearers. We carry the light. So we must constantly eat and partake of the divine nature. The divine nature is Christ Jesus. So we eat the word. We speak the word. Because you can't eat the word without speaking the word. Why? Because what you speak is what you eat. Has everybody got it? So you speak the word, you eat the word. And you drink the blood. How do you drink the blood? Because it's the spirit. I must sow. So I sing. As I sing, I drink. Has everybody got it? Amen. Ephesians 5. There's a lot of good people out there. They're just very dumb. Because there's a difference between goodness and righteousness. There's a tree of the knowledge of good and evil. And there's a tree of righteousness. Ephesians chapter 5 and verse 1. Therefore be what? Imitators of God as dear children, and walk in love as Christ also has loved us and given himself for us, an offering and a sacrifice to God for a sweet-smelling aroma. But fornication and all uncleanness or covetousness, let it not even be named among you as is fitting for saints. Neither filthiness, nor foolishness, nor foolish what? Talking, nor coarse jesting, which is not fitting, but rather giving of thanks. For this you know, that no fornicator, unclean person, or covetous man who is an idolater has any inheritance in the kingdom of Christ and God. Let no one deceive you with empty words, for because of these things, the wrath of God comes upon the sons of disobedience. So we see deception is promoting children of wrath through the prince of power of error, Antichrist spirit, bringing ungodly counsel. Therefore, do not what? Be partakers of them, but be partakers of the divine nature by eating the word and drinking the spirit. For you were once darkness, but now you are light in the Lord. Walk as children of light. For the fruit of the Spirit is in all goodness, righteousness, and truth, finding out what is acceptable to the Lord. And have no fellowship with unfruitful works of darkness, but rather what? Expose them. For it is shameful even to speak of those things which are done by them in secret. But all things that are exposed are made manifest by the light. For whatever makes manifest is light. Therefore, he says, awake, you who sleep, and arise from the dead, and Christ will give you light. See, then you walk circumspectly, not as fools, but as wise, redeeming the time, because the days are evil. This generation is evil. Therefore, do not be unwise, but understand what the will of the Lord is. And do not be drunk with wine, in which is dissipation, but be filled with the Holy Spirit. Praise God. And I want to close at Daniel 12. Light bearers. Daniel chapter 12. So get ready. Don't get offended. Stand bold in the Lord and the power of his might. Don't be a man pleaser, be a God pleaser. Because God's getting ready to bless your socks off. If you're in position. Daniel 12 and verse 1. And at that time Michael shall stand up, the great prince who stands watch over the sons of your people. And there shall be a time of trouble, such as never was since there was a nation. So that means Israel had to become a nation. It's called Jacob's trouble which would be 7 years of tribulation, which we have not entered yet. I don't think, anyways. Even to that time, and at that time your people shall be what? Delivered. Everyone who is found written in the book of what? The book of life. And many of those who sleep in the dust of the earth shall awake, some to everlasting life, and some to shame and everlasting contempt. Those who are wise shall what? Shine like the brightness of the firmament. And those who turn many to righteousness like the stars forever and ever. But you, Daniel, shut up the words, the seal, the book until the time of the end. Many shall run to and fro, and knowledge shall increase. Is knowledge increasing? You bet. Yeah, technology is increasing tremendously. That's where the ungodly counsel is coming from. But God is also using it to rescue, isn't he? Then I, Daniel, looked, and there stood two others, one on this riverbank and one on the other riverbank. And one said to the man clothed in linen, who was above the waters of the river, how long should a fulfillment of these wonders be? Then I heard the man clothed in linen, who was above the waters of the river. What river? The river of life. That's why we're river children. When he held up his hand, right hand and his left hand to heaven and swore by him who lives forever that it shall be for a time, times and half time, 3.5 years. And when the power of the holy people has been completely shattered, all these things shall be finished. Although I heard, I did not understand. Then I said, my Lord, what shall be the end of these things? And he said, go your way, Daniel, for the words are closed up and sealed to the time of the end. Many shall be purified and made white and refined, but the wicked shall do wickedly, and none of the wicked shall understand, but the wise shall what? The wise shall understand. So the wicked will not understand, will it? And more imposters will come. More and more wickedness will come. There'll be more and more false prophets and false Christians and false Christ. More religions will pop up. We are in a generation of the most crooked and perverse. But thank God that he who is in you is greater than he who is in the world. Amen. That no weapon formed against us can prosper. Amen. That we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. Amen. And if God be for us, who can be against us? And to God be the glory. And everybody said, amen. Amen.